First of all, I'm married to the prettiest girl in town, and she still is. Did you tell me to say that correctly?
Yeah, I think you got it right. Well, the year was 1948, and I was a freshman at Georgia State College for Women. And if you didn't have a boyfriend already back at home, you didn't get one there because we didn't have any men except the professors and very few of those. So my sister was 5 years younger than I am, and she had started school at home, and I had heard that she had a man teacher for the year. So I decided, well, if I was going to be a teacher, that might be a good idea to just check him out. So they allowed us to go home from college twice a quarter. So all my times at home, I would arrange to stop by the school to pick up my sister and take her on home with me. But Robert didn't know why I was stopping there. I was really stopping just to check him out, see what he looked like. So on one occasion when I stopped by, we had a small, short conversation at the door, and he said, "You might drop me a letter sometimes." So I thought about it. We didn't have telephones in my hometown at that time, and the only way of communication was really by letter. So several weeks passed, and I got to thinking about it, so I decided I would write him a letter. And then I waited for a couple of weeks and didn't hear from him, and I thought, oh, well, he didn't mean that after all. So, but the day I was to leave college for the summer to go home, I went by the post office and I had a letter from him. And he said he'd like to come to see me on Thursday night. So when I got home, he showed up for his announced date. And I guess you'd say we just lived happily ever after, even though it was 2 years before we got married. And we had a home wedding with friends and relatives there, and we had a garden reception.
Evening shadows make as long as I